Did you know there are 19 symptoms of kidney disease? Well, I'm going to talk about that and more coming right up. Hello, Kidney Warriors! James here with Dadvice TV, your online kidney health coach. And this is video number 61, helping you fight kidney disease and kick it to the curb. These videos help educate you, inspire you, and motivate you to take your health seriously, to become your best advocate, to push your doctors to stick to your diet so that you can have the most energy, the most health, and the longest life with kidney disease. Now, in this episode, we're going to talk about the 19 symptoms that you may have kidney disease. Now, finding out that you have it early is extremely important. So if you have any of these symptoms or you just worry about your kidney health, see your doctor, have them do some tests and find out how your kidneys are doing. Now, when it comes to symptoms, a lot of people may only get a few symptoms or they may not get any symptoms at all, or so they think because they kind of ignore them. It's important if you find that you have any of the symptoms on this list, or again, you worry about your kidneys, go to your doctor, have them do some tests. Only with tests will you know how your kidneys are doing. And kidney disease is not the only problems that can cause these symptoms. So don't worry if you got them until you know. And then once you know, start making changes. Get on that great diet, work with your doctor to improve your health like I did. Stage 5, told I had no hope at all. Dialysis was my only option and a transplant. That was over a year ago. Look at me. I'm doing better than ever. Remember, I just got labs 2 days ago. Best labs ever. Woo! My bun, oh, almost normal. Creatinine, lower, which what's that mean with my GFR? Up. All right. So let's get into the symptoms. First, we have persistent fatigue, always feeling tired, even when you wake up. Now, when your kidneys start to decline, one of the things that they do less of is creating a hormone called erythropoietin. This works with your body to create more red blood cells. And red blood cells work with hemoglobins to go and get oxygen and deliver it to your organs. When you're creating less red blood cells, you're getting less oxygen and you're pretty much suffocating your organs. This is known as anemia, extremely common with those with chronic kidney disease. But the good news is anemia can easily be treated and even avoided with changes to your diet. Next, we have feeling cold even when those around you feel warm. This again is related to that anemia. In addition to carrying oxygen, those red blood cells help deliver nutrients and heat to your body. Not enough of that, and you're feeling cold. Next, we have shortness of breath, even after just a little bit of activity. And this can be caused by one of two things. We got that anemia problem we just talked about, getting less oxygen to your organs. Also, this could be a buildup of fluid in your lungs. Next, feeling faint, dizzy, or weak. This again is related to that reduction in oxygen getting to all your organs. Next, trouble thinking clearly. A lack of oxygen to the brain makes it difficult to think clearly and to concentrate. Next, we have high blood pressure or blood pressure that's difficult to manage. When your kidneys get damaged, they lose the ability to properly regulate the fluid, hormones, acids, and salts in your blood, and this can lead to increased blood pressure. Next, we have itchiness. Oh, this itchiness that just will not go away. You can scratch it as much as you want. Lotions, creams, none of them are gonna help. What happens is as your kidney function declines, the toxins in your blood increase, and that causes this itchiness. Next, we have swelling in your hands, your feet, your ankles, your lower legs. As your kidney function is reduced, fluids start to build up in these areas. Next, we have a swollen or puffy face, again related to that fluid buildup. Next, there's a metallic taste in your mouth, especially when you eat food. This is caused by waste building up in your bloodstream, known as uremia. Food will taste metallic, especially red meat. You may not feel like eating and you might start losing weight. And next is ammonia breath. And boy, whew, this is a tough one. This is that uremia, the waste building up in your bloodstream. You actually are releasing some of the waste products, some of the ammonia from your tongue, and it's giving you that awful breath. Next, upset stomach, nausea, and even vomiting. This again is related to that buildup of waste products in your blood known as uremia. You're not gonna feel like eating much, and whatever you do eat, you might have trouble keeping it down. Next, we have muscle cramps. Now, this is extremely common in people with kidney disease and is overlooked so often. As waste products build up in your bloodstream, you're gonna be eating less, and chances are you won't be getting enough of the nutrients you need, such as salt, and these imbalances are gonna cause muscle cramps, muscle twitching, and other nerve problems. Next, we have back pain. Now, this is a very common one when your kidneys are really starting to swell. You will have back pain where your kidneys are located, which is your lower upper-ish back, and you may only have it on one side or the other. Next, we have sleep problems. As toxins build up in your blood, you're gonna have trouble falling and staying asleep. Insomnia, restless leg syndrome are all very common for those with kidney problems. Next is getting up throughout the night to go to the bathroom. You're gonna notice that you have to go more often, more times, and the amount that comes out is not the normal amount. Next is foamy urine. When you start to leak protein into your urine, which shouldn't happen, it will get foamy. Next, brown, purplish, or even red urine. As your kidneys get damaged, they may start leaking blood into your urine, and you'll see it. The color will change. And last, pressure or difficulty urinating. Your kidneys aren't working as well, pulling fluid out of your body and sending it to your bladder. So you're gonna feel pressure as you try to go to the bathroom, or very little will be coming out. And there you go, Dadvice TV's 19 symptoms of kidney problems. Now remember, these don't mean you've got kidney disease. But if you have one or more of these, or you just worry about, hey, how's my kidneys doing? Go visit your doctor. They'll do some simple tests. They will let you know. And if you do have some kidney problems, don't worry. The sooner you find out, the sooner you can make changes. Changes to your diet, changes to your lifestyle to start kicking kidney disease to the curb. The earlier you can get on top of things, the better your chances are of delaying or even completely avoiding ever needing dialysis. And did your doctor just diagnose you and tell you, hey, you're stage 4, there's no hope, you're stage 3, there's nothing you can do? That is wrong. I was diagnosed stage 5, kidney failure. My kidneys gave up on me. Oh, it was awful. Oh, I looked like the walking dead. My face was awful. I couldn't eat anything for days. All these symptoms, I practically had all of them. Going into the ER, heart problems, in the ICU, no hope. Pretty much, I felt like the doctor just told me, give up. Here's DaVita, go visit them. They'll get you on dialysis. No. I did research. I discovered there are other options. There's something called conservative management, diet and lifestyle changes. I found doctors that understood that, that worked with me, that looked at food as either healthful for you, they're gonna improve you, help your health, or they're poison, they're gonna harm you. And I said, get rid of the poison. Give me the good stuff. Not too much, not too little. Find that Goldilocks zone. Give my body what it needs. Look at my labs. What do I need now? Let's keep getting them better and better and better every single time. Every time I get labs, new strategy. What am I gonna do to make them even better next time? And look at me, so much better. Am I on dialysis? No, never had it. I hope never to. Do I have any symptoms? I had all these symptoms. Today, none of them. I'm out there, I'm walking, I'm jogging, I started jumping rope. I did it. I came back from zero chance, quote, zero chance, I was told. There was no hope for me. I took it on myself. I found doctors that believed in diet, lifestyle changes, fighting kidney disease, not giving up, not being another stat for them, another failure in helping people. I found doctors that said, we're gonna help you. You're gonna get better. You can live your life. Don't worry, James, we're gonna help you. I followed their advice. I worked with them. I made the sacrifices. I made the changes. And look at this, I got my life back. And you can too. All right, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.